हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू एक्वायर आईएएस। सो टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट ए न्यू सीरीज ऑन एनवायरनमेंट। सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द चैप्टर वन ऑफ द शंकर गणेश इकोलॉजी द टू। दिस इज़ ए क्वेश्चन बेस्ड सीरीज। ओके, सो द क्वेश्चंस विल बी फ्रॉम द पर्टिकुलर चैप्टर्स इट्सेल्फ। There is no amalgamations or there is no merging of any kind of other related things. So it is purely based upon the chapter's informations. Okay, so the questions are generated from the particular chapters. So we will discuss daily one or two chapters. So within 15 to 20 days we will complete the entire environment series. Okay, so for personal assistance you can call me or text me further 9640123412, as well as you can download the short notes of the Hindu PDF daily, which is most important for UPSC prelims, mains, as well as interview examinations. So without being late, let's get started. So this is the series which we are going to see today, that is questions on ecology chapter 1 of the Shankar IAS. okay, so the first chapter is ecology. Okay, so we will see, we are not going to discuss even a single definition what is meant by ecology. Okay, this is only a purely based upon the question series. Okay, question and answers, that's it, there is nothing else here. Okay, so let us see our first question is, so let me tell you one thing before seeing the answers, just pause the video and try to attempt these questions. If you are not getting that, it's not an issue, you can learn from the books. Okay, so we'll see what is our first question, that is ecology is defined as a scientific study of the relationship. So which is the following is correct behind this? So option A is plants and animals, option B is plants and organisms, option C plants and living beings, option D all of the above. So here how can you say about this question? Okay, so the thing is, the option, the right answer is option D is the right answer. So option D is the right answer. Next we see about the second question in this, in which of the following contains reference to the ecological concept. Okay, in which of the following contains a reference to the ecological concept? What does the question tries to say that from which of the following the concept of the ecological, okay, the in which of the following there is a ecological concept in this things. Okay, so there is a four options in this. Option number A is the Vedas and the Samhitas, option number B the Brahmins, okay, the Brahmanas and the Aranyakas Upanishads, option C A and B, option D none of the above. So here your option will be the C. Okay, option C, both A and B. So let us see about the explanations here, what could be the explanations for these questions. Okay, so let us move. So this is your explanations for both the questions. Question number one is ecology is defined as a scientific study between the relationship of the living organisms with each other and with their environment. So one can say that living organisms plus environment, whatever the environment it is there. Okay, for example we can, just a second, for example we can say a bacteria plus its environment, or else a fish plus its environment. Now for fish it has two types of environments, that is internal and external. So in these both we can call it as ecology. Okay, so in this both means whether the fish is on ground or else it is in the water, in both circumstances we can say that it is defined as the ecology, because it is combination of the living organisms plus the environment. For this purpose it will come under the ecology. Okay, so this is the definition of the ecology. I hope you understood very well. Next we see further the classical text. Here in the second question it is asking that then which of the following contains the ecological concepts, that is Vedas, Samhitas, Brahmanas and the Aranyaka Upanishads. So our options here, the explanation for the second question is the classical text of the Vedas period, such as the classical text of the Vedic period, such as the Samhitas, Brahmanas, Aranyakas, Upanishads contains a reference to the ecological concepts. So this is the factual based questions. Okay, this is not the some sort of conceptual, but it has some sort of facts, which is most important for UPSC prelims. Same kind of questions can be asked in your UPSC prelims. So just be focused on these facts. That is, this Samhitas and the Brahmanas, Aranyakas, Upanishads. These will contain the text of the ecological concept. Okay. Next we see further questions. What are they for this? So third question is, which of the following shows people during the ancient period had a good understanding of plants and animals ecology. Okay, plant and animal ecology. So from this context, from this statement, there I have given the four options here. You can see, read out. Option A is Charaka Samhita. Second one is Sushruta Samhita. Option C is both A and B, and option D is none of the above. So option C is the correct answer, that is both A and B. Okay, next we see next question, that is fourth one. The environment is defined as living things, non-living things, both A and B, none. So which of the following is the right option? So here your option will be C would be the right answer, because environment, it will contains both living organisms plus non-living organisms. Okay, so here you can say the option number C is the right answer. See, you can go this by even by elimination method. I'll tell you in what perspective you have to follow the elimination method. Okay, so let me tell you one thing. Okay, so here it is talking about the environment. So what is environment? First of all, environment includes both living plus non-living. Okay, so in this situation, one is easily understandable that both A and B are the right options. So if you are not getting what is environment and it doesn't have living things and non-living things, then your preparation is very much backwards. So please be focused on that. Okay, next we see further the explanations for the questions 3 and 4. That is, you can read out here. Let me read out for you. The Charaka Samhita and the surgical strictures. Okay, the Charaka Samhita and the surgical text Sushruta Samhita shows that people during this period has a good understanding of the plants and animals. Okay, next, the Charaka Samhita contains information about the air, land, water, seasons were indispensable for life, and that polluted air, water were injurious to health. Okay, so these are the indispensable for the life, which are the most polluted air and water were injurious to the health. Okay, it was said in the Charaka and the Sushruta Samhita. Okay, so these two you have to remember. Next we see about the explanation for the fourth questions, that is everything which is surrounded. What is an environment? I think yes, what is the environment is defined as. Okay, so for this we will see here, and everything that surrounds or affects an organism's during its lifetime is collectively known as environment. Okay, the environment is defined as the sum of total living, non-living components, influence and events surrounding an organism is called as environment. Now let me tell you little bit, taking an example here, फॉर योर बेटर अंडरस्टैंडिंग. ओके, सो टेक एन एग्जाम्पल ऑफ रॉक. रॉक विच इज नॉन लिविंग. ओके, विच इज नॉन लिविंग थिंग. इवन दो इट विल अफेक्ट ड्यू टू द वेदर सिस्टम्स. हाउ? दैट इज वेदरिंग प्रोसेस. दैट इज बाय द इंसुलेशन. Due to the process of the insulation, it will take wearing and tearing. Okay, in this process, it will break down the rock. So even the, I mean, what I am trying to say here is, here it is clearly mentioned that whatever the organisms during its life, the surrounding effects, everything that surrounds or affects an organism during its lifetime. Okay, there is a lifetime for the rocks. Okay. Just like we see that there is Deccan trap has been evolved during this period. Okay, so in the similar way the rocks has the ages, so it will affect due to the weathering process. Okay, next we see further questions, that is fifth question. So which of the following are abiotic factors? Okay friends, so what is the meaning of abiotic and biotic? So let me tell you one thing, I mean give you a hint about this. First of all, biotic and abiotic. Biotic is living thing and abiotic is non-living thing. Okay, biotic is living being and abiotic is non-living. Okay, so here he is asking about abiotic, which is non-living things. So energy, is it biotic or non-biotic? Just think about it, pause the video and think about these options. That is, option number A is energy, B radiation, C temperature and heat flow, D non-green plants, E decomposers, F parasites, G symbionts. Okay, so now pause the video and try to attempt this answer by yourself. Now I am going to tell you the answer. The answer will be A is the right answer. Okay, because option number A, B, C are the abiotic factor. That is, energy, radiation and temperature are the heat flows and the heat flows. Okay, next, non-green plants. That means the other plants which are meant for the aromatic plants. Okay, many other plants which are non-green. Okay, like just like grasses which are not plants. Okay, so decomposers, these are the living things, parasites and symbionts. So these are all comes under the biotic factor. So let us see about the factors. What are the factors which comes under abiotic and biotic factors? Okay, so let us go speed. So these are the components of the environment, that is abiotic and biotic. So abiotic contains, here are the list of that is energy, radiation, temperature and heat flow, water, atmospheric gas and winds, fire, gravity, topography, soil, geologic substratum. Okay, next, in biotic, if you see about the biotic, that is living things, there is green plants, non-green plants, decomposers, okay, parasites, symbionts, animals and man. So these are all come under the biotic and abiotic factors, and these are the most responsible for the all other things. Okay, next we see next question about 6-1. That is, external environment of fish abiotic consists of. So what is the external environment of fish consist of? So students, in most of the case, they'll get into the hasty reading and they'll miss out the logic behind this question and they'll think that it is most important. Okay, like you try to solve the questions, pause the video and try to solve this. Okay, right now I'm telling the answers for this. So where does a student will get confused regarding these questions? That is, he'll confuse at he won't read about the abiotic factors. He will just read external environment of fish consist of. Okay, he won't see any sort of abiotic or biotic factors. So he is asking particularly about the abiotic factor. Abiotic means which is non-living thing, just we are red. Okay, so what comes under the abiotic? That is light, temperature and oxygen. Okay, so here our option will be the D is the right answer, all of the above. So option D is the right answer, right? Next we see about 7th question. It is internal environment of the fish. Here we saw about the external environment of fish. Now we see internal environment of fish. He is not asking about the living things or non-living things. Okay, so let us see the option first of all. So what is the question he given here is, which of the following statement is given correct? So he gave the two statements. From out of that, which is the statement, which one of the following statement is correct or not, we have to choose the answers depending on that. Okay, so let us see. Option number A is, it is enclosed by the outer surface. It is enclosed by the outer body surface. Okay, read out carefully. It is enclosed by the outer body surface. Second option is, it is the internal environment is relatively stable as compared to external environment. So think about this, which one is correct answer, please tell me in the comment box. Okay, so let me tell you the answer here. The option A, let us check about the option A first. It is closed by the outer body surface, isn't it? Is it correct or wrong? It is correct, because water is surrounded by the earth's surface, right? So A is enclosed by the outer body surface, is it right? I hope you got the statement one. Next we go about the statement two. The internal environment is relatively stable as compared to the external environment. Yes, obviously it is correct, because in external environment we have temperature increase and reduction, rainfall, we have dust, we have human participation, we have, that is anthropological disturbances we have. Okay, even though in water they have, but it is as compared to very much less. Okay, so option B is also correct. So on this basis analysis, on the basis of these analysis, we can say that option C is the right answer, that is both A and B. Okay, so let us see next question, that is 8th one. The components of the ecosystem and the environment are same. Okay, so from this, which of the following statements is correct? Okay, you have to choose which of the following statement is correct from the following options. Okay, so just a second, let me erase this. Yeah, sorry. So which of the following statement is correct? Choose the correct statement. So option number A, the components of ecosystem and environment are same. Okay, option number B, the components of ecosystem and environment are not same. So which of the statement is correct out of these two? So if you have read the chapter 1 of the ecology, Shankaraya's ecology chapter, then you can easily attempt this question. So the option number A is correct and option number 2 is wrong. So obviously option number 2 is wrong, means option B, C, D will be wrong. So option A is a right answer. Okay, there is nothing much to give an explanation in this. Okay, so next we move further. Substratum refers to, what does the substratum refers to? In UPSC prelims, such kind of questions are very much frequently asked, so please be focused on such kind of questions. Okay, so we move to the options. An underlying layer or substances of the ground. Option number B, substances above the surface. Option number C, an underlying layer or substances of the water. Okay, here you can see this, here it is given the ground and here it is given the water, and option D is none of the above. So which of the following statement is correct regarding these options? So option number A is the right answer, because substratum is a layer or substances of the ground, okay, not under the water, it is only on the layers of the ground. Okay, so next we see further, next question, that is 10th one. Inorganic component consists of, so what are the inorganic components consist of? Option number A is carbon dioxide and water. Option B, sulfur and nitrate. Option C, phosphates and iron ions of various metals. Option number D is all of the above. So all of the above, option number D is the right answer. Okay, next we see what does the next we see autotrophs are. Okay, so here what the question is trying to see is, what is a autotrophs, means which of the following will include in this. Option number A is primary producers. Option number B, macro producers. Option number C, micro consumers. Option number D, none of the above. So here the option number A is the right answer. Okay, that is primary producers. Autotrophs consist of only primary producers, but not macro, micro producers or consumers. Okay, so next we move on. Oh, we gave the explanation for 11th question as well, so you can see the explanation for 11th question. So yeah, primary producers, what are primary producers? Primary producers are the autotrophs, that is autotrophs is also called as primary producers or self-nourishing. Okay, that is autotrophs, it can generate its own food by the process of the photosynthesis. It does not require any sort of external energy except photosynthesis, I mean except sunlight. Okay, and by that, the using of the photosynthesis, it will prepare its own food, and the secondary and tertiary consumers cannot produce their own foods. Okay, and a third, tertiary consumers are most probably dependent on the secondary producers, secondary consumers and the primary producers. Okay, so what will come under the primary producers? The examples are, best examples are plants. Okay, so what is the secondary consumers? That is cow. Okay, next, third is tertiary consumers, that concern men who are dependent on both plants and animals, that is secondary and primary consumers, producers. Okay, next we say primary producers are basically green plants and certain bacteria and algae. Here you can see certain bacteria and algae. Okay, micro consumers, that is saprotrophs, decomposers or osmotrophs. Here micro consumers also called as saprotrophs, decomposers or osmotrophs. Okay, they are bacteria and fungi which obtain energy and nutrients by decomposing dead organic substances, detritus of plants and animals origin. So what is meant by detritus? That is dead plants of, that is dead plants and animals. Okay, so we saw the explanation for this. Now we see next question, that is 12. Here is your question. Ecotone is a zone of junction between the two or more diverse. What is next? So that is option number A, ecosystem. Option number B, बायोम ऑप्शन नंबर सी, कम्युनिटी ऑप्शन नंबर डी, इकोटोन। ओके सो चूज द करेक्ट आंसर बिटवीन फ्रॉम द फॉलोइंग ऑप्शंस। सो रीड द क्वेश्चन केयरफुली। इकोटोन इज अ जोन ऑफ जंक्शंस बिटवीन टू आर मोर डाइवर्स इकोसिस्टम इज द राइट आंसर। ओके सो ऑप्शन नंबर ए इज ए विल बी द योर आंसर। ओके सो द बेस्ट एग्जाम्पल इज हियर इज योर एक्सप्लेनेशन। द मैंग्रोव फॉरेस्ट रिप्रेजेंट्स, ओके मैंग्रोव फॉरेस्ट रिप्रेजेंट्स ए इकोटोन बिटवीन द मरेन एंड टेरेस्ट्रियल इकोसिस्टम। वॉट इज दिस मरेन? मरेन मीन्स वाटर एंड टेरेस्ट्रियल मीन्स लैंड। सो दिस इज कंजंक्शन पॉइंट, दिस इज अ कंटेंशन पॉइंट ऑफ द मरेन एंड टेरेस्ट्रियल इकोसिस्टम। सो दिस इज कॉल्ड एज अ इकोसिस्टम। ओके इकोसिस्टम, इकोसिस्टम इज अ जोन ऑफ जंक्शन बिटवीन द टू और मोर डाइवर्स इकोसिस्टम। सो ऑप्शन नंबर ए इज द राइट आंसर। सो व्हाट आर द एग्जांपल्स ऑफ दिस? दिस ग्रासलैंड, एस्चुरीज एंड रिवर बैंक्स। ओके सो नेक्स्ट वी सी फर्दर 13th क्वेश्चन। चूज द करेक्ट आंसर फ्रॉम द फॉलोइंग। ऑप्शन नंबर ए, सो ऑप्शन नंबर ए नीच इज यूनिक फंक्शनल रोल और प्लेस ऑफ ए स्पीशीज इन एन इकोसिस्टम। ओके ऑप्शन नंबर बी इज ए नीच इज ए सिंथेसिस फंक्शनल रोल ऑफ प्लेस, रोल और प्लेस ऑफ ए स्पीशीज इन एन इकोसिस्टम। ओके ऑप्शन नंबर सी इज ए नीच इज ए यूनिक फंक्शनल रोल और प्लेस ऑफ ए स्पीशीज इन एन इकोटोन। ओके नेक्स्ट ऑप्शन नंबर डी इज ए नीच इज ए सिंथेसिस फंक्शनल रोल और प्लेस ऑफ ए स्पीशीज इन एन इकोटोन। ओके सो विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग इज द राइट ऑप्शन? यू हैव टू चूज वन ऑफ द फॉलोइंग। ओके सो द राइट आंसर विल बी हियर, ऑप्शन नंबर ए इज द राइट आंसर। ओके बिकॉज ए नीच इज ए यूनिक फंक्शनल रोल और प्लेसेस ऑफ द स्पीशीज इन एन इकोसिस्टम। ओके इट डज नॉट कंटेन्स एनी सॉर्ट ऑफ इकोसिस्टम और एनी काइंड ऑफ सिंथेसिस। ओके सो दीज आर द डिफरेंस इन दिस डेफिनेशन। सो बाय दिस आई होप यू अंडरस्टैंड अबाउट दिस। ओके सो दैट इज इट फॉर दिस वीडियो एंड टुमारो वी विल बी बैक विद द चैप्टर 2। ओके चैप्टर 2 ऑफ द शंकर IAS एंड चैप्टर 3 ऑफ द शंकर IAS। ओके एज सुन एज वी डूइंग द चैप्टर 2 वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द चैप्टर 3। आई लेट यू नो whether we are going to do chapter 3 tomorrow or not, but chapter 2 is for damn sure, that is 100% we have to prepare tomorrow. Okay so be focused, stay concentrated, be active. If you have any doubts, any problems, any sort of, not only regarding UPSC, regarding personal problems also I can solve that. Okay so you can contact me at 9640123012. Okay this is my contact number, you can contact anytime. Okay so I hope you enjoyed the video. Please do subscribe for Aqua IAS. Thank you very much. Have a great day.